Yo, what's up guys, Matty the Nerf Guy here, broadcasting live from the Matty Lair. Welcome to Tagbacks, the show where we look at a blaster from the past, see what it offers us today in the present Nerf hobby, playing field, and what mighty potential it possibly has. In this episode, we'll be looking at the Stampede. Now, before I get into this and all, I want to thank my good friend, Joaquin Nova, on Facebook. I had bought this from him, and in a group called Nerf Buy, Sell, and Trade, and I got this for 55 bucks. Well, not really 55 bucks, it was like it was like 55 bucks after shipping and all, and I know these things might go for a lot, you know, for Nerf collectors, so I got it for a pretty reasonably good price. Now, on into the tag back. This thing was the pinnacle of flywheels, or not the pinnacle, the birth of flywheels and the 18 Dart magazine. When this came out, for the first time, you had things that required no cocking, no springs. Well, it did have a spring to operate the firing mechanism, but it didn't require unlike the Maverick, we had to pull back, fire, pull back, fire, or the Recon, we had to pull back, fire, or where you had, on the long shot, we had to cock back the mechanism and fire, it required no cocking and no springs. Well, this still didn't require a spring, but it didn't require any constant cocking. All you had to do was just kept it from firing, but all you had to do was flip off the switch and hold your finger down on the trigger. It also came with, mine didn't come with this, bipod thing here, but it came with this, foregrip thing. This is the only other thing I've seen that came with a foregrip that was detachable, that also came with a mounted, that also came with a bipod inside. You know, it also came with a deflector shield. So when you're aiming like this, or let's say you're hiding behind cover, you know, anything that comes at you, it'll deflect incoming darts. So, making it really, really good. So if you are hiding behind, let's say, a couch or something, and you were firing, you know, it was pretty cool. Now, this part right here, I say, I want to take this off because I do not like this part. And you may ask why there are drawbacks to this thing. Well, although, I'll put this back on there for a minute. Dang it, I'm sorry, I can't get it back on there. Anyway, this thing right here, though, in my mind, was not really a flaw, but it was a drawback. When you attached it to the front of it, now I got it back on, when you attached it to the front of it, yes, it did keep you safe from getting tagged from oncoming fire from your opponents, but sadly, when you were trying to aim down the iron sight here, it impeded your view because all you could see was that part right there. So if you wanted to aim down, you'd have to take it off and either like put it on the top here, which in my mind just makes it look really ugly and all that. But another drawback was it had to run on batteries to operate the flywheels. It required 6D batteries to run. Now, you can see that I have another battery tray in here. This is the one that came with it. My Facebook friend Joe Quinova added a free battery tray onto this thing, modded to run on AA batteries rather than the 6D batteries and all. This thing is not very big and bulky by itself. I mean, I'm an adult and I can hold it fairly easy with just one hand. But if you're a kid, it might be a little harder because it's a lot bigger than a kid and all. So yeah, also, the batteries kind of tended to add weight to it. Where I work, we sell we sell batteries where I work, and I've seen batteries sold everywhere, and the D batteries they're pretty heavy. In a pack of like a 9 or 10, I believe. So yeah, our drawback was this shield right here, and this thing right here, the battery tray. But the good thing though is it came with more, I guess you could say it came with more magazines than any other Nerf blaster at the time. Why? Well, not only did it come with 60 darts, it came with three 18-dot magazines in a quick reload clip, as the on the box it and on the box as it called, a quick 6-dot reload clip. Now me, I like mine without the shield because I think it looks cooler. But some people think it looks cool with a shield. Now, this thing also did come in a few different flavors. It came in the traditional, Stampede Ecs. It also came in the Sonic Green, in the Sonic from the Sonic Green series, or the Sonic Green line, where it was just green plastic and all. And then there was one where it said Sonic Ecs 50, which is rare. Now, the Sonic Ecs 50, whatever you want for your Nerf news back then, there was a leak, or whatever you might call it, saying that the Stampede was coming with a 50-dart drum. Now that never came out, and I don't think it was ever made. There were drawings for it, designs for it, but it never really came out. So all that came out for it was just the Stampede ECS 50. So, yeah, but if you looked at it back then, the thing never came out. So this is pretty cool. Not only did you have more magazines than any other Nerf blaster, but at the time, you had more tactical whales than any other Nerf blaster. You had a total of 5 tactical whales. One on top for any optics you might have chosen. Another right here. One at the bottom. One right over here. And 2 on the sides. Well, that was a total of 6, a total of 6 tack rails. That was more than any other Nerf blaster at the time. Most of them only came with 1 or 2, or 2 or 3. Like, the Recon only came with 3, 1 at the top of its priming mechanism, and 2 on the barrel. So, yeah, but this was the pinnacle and practicality of a Nerf war. For the first time ever, You were able to switch your shots, go single shot, or just go full auto on the battlefield. And for the first time ever, you had a blaster shield. Now, granted, this thing does impede your view when you're trying to look down the iron sight, but then again, it does come with this thing right here, a cool cage-looking paint job where you can look through it. Now, a lot of people, here I'm going to step out of screen here for a second, a lot of people prefer a 35-dart drum with this. Why? Because it's a 35-dart drum that holds more darts than any other Nerf magazine. I prefer mine like this. So, I'm gonna step back out and get back my 18-dart magazine here. Sorry about that, guys. Now, anyway, so, this isn't actually my new NVZ primary. Old? Yes. Still practical? Yes. Now, you may be wondering and all, but what about the rapid strike? What about the strife and all that? As good as the rapid strike and all that is, one thing that cannot be denied is the thing that gets the glory in the end is the Stampede. Why? It was the first ever flywheel blaster. Now, granted and all, granted you might have had there was a 90s thing and all, I guess it was a predecessor to the Nerf buzzsaw, is where you went. I guess you had a thing where it went like that. You had to prime it, and it shot. It was a ball blaster, you know. But that wasn't operated on flywheel. I mean, technically, it was. I guess you could call it a flywheel on the buzzsaw, but this thing right here actually webbed, you know, and fired. Now, a few drawbacks to this thing is, yes, the shield, the battery tray, but also is it's a flywheel. When flywheels rev, they give away your position. So right here, this thing was probably meant for support when on your Nerf team. It was meant for support rather than hiding. Why? Well, Because, I mean, when you were revving this thing, it would give you away. So, if you're in hiding mode, then you gotta... If you're hiding and supporting your team, you gotta use the shield. But this thing was the pinnacle of practicality at the time for the Nerf Wars. I really love this blaster, and I really hope that if you can... This is not sold on stores anymore. You can find it at, like, at Goodwill's, garage sales. I found this thing on a Facebook group called Nerf Buy, Sell, and Trade, where basically me and fellow Nerfers, we all just, if we don't want, if we see we have something in our Nerf arsenal that we want to sell, we sell it. If we want to trade, we trade it, you know? Or if we want to buy something, we'll just buy something, you know? So that's pretty much where I get most of my blasters now, is from Nerf Buy, Sell, and Trade on Facebook. So, yeah. I would highly recommend this thing to anyone because why? It's the original first flywheel blaster, and I mean, also it's just really awesome. I mean, the looks of this thing, the ergonomics of this thing are pretty cool. The cosmetic is pretty cool. I'm not going to do any cosmetic mods to this thing or anything that's going to be made kept as is for NVZ. I would recommend this thing to anyone because yes, yes, modern technology for flywheels is really good, but in the end, when, let's say, all is said and done, this thing gets the glory. Why? It was the first flywheel blaster in the Nerf arsenal. Thank you guys for watching. Do you guys have any tagbacks you'd like me to do? Any versus videos you'd like me to do? Or any reviews and loadout videos? If so, please comment below. This is Maddie the Nerf Guy signing off. Peace and hair grease, guys. Peace out.